It's bedtime at the Bunny Rothman family's house, but this isn't like any other night. Tonight, there's a new reality, a new president in America.
What was your initial reaction when you heard the news?
Do you know, the thing is that with the elections, of course, there is no when you heard the news. It's this long, killing me softly process.
Esra is an American living and working here in Abu Dhabi. We first met her at an election viewing party that we live streamed on Facebook.
I just want to play this clip for you. Sure. So we can see. This is what you were telling us yesterday.
I'm hesitant, I'm worried, I don't know what to expect on the other end.
And this is what she thinks today.
I don't know. It's unpredictable. It's as unpredictable as the tweets that come out. Like, you don't know what's gonna come.
That uncertainty is casting its shadow over Muslims around the world. During his campaign, Donald Trump proposed a temporary ban on Muslims from entering the United States. And he wasn't exactly clear about how or even if he'd try to improve relations with the Muslim world. Many are now stunned that Trump was elected. In my opinion, this is the worst decision that America has made, this teacher in Baghdad says. He will get America into a lot of trouble. Trump's policy about Muslims, about immigrants, it's really bad, this tech worker in Indonesia says. Even here, in this remote Syrian refugee camp where people struggle just to survive, the news and the disappointment spread fast. We were surprised by the victory of a racist and sectarian president who's against the Syrian revolution. If we had a little hope to go back home, we don't anymore. Hope is what Esra Bunny Rothman is left clinging to. She's a woman, a Muslim, and an African American, the very same demographics that voted in large numbers for Hillary Clinton. Now she wonders if people like her still have a place in President-elect Donald Trump's America.
Are you worried about going back now?
I am. Most obviously, the feeling of a displaced refugee.
Is that how you'll feel?
I absolutely feel like a displaced refugee. Because
in your own country?
Absolutely.
And as she puts her one-year-old son to bed, her hope is that Donald Trump, the president, will be different from Donald Trump, the candidate. Muhammad Lila, CNN, Abu Dhabi.